Hello, everyone. Evening. Am I audible? Okay. No, nothing like that. I got a question. Site ओपन नहीं हो रही है सुबह से. हाँ,
है
साइट इज ओपनिंग, देर इज नो इश्यू. ओके गाइज, सो शैल वी स्टार्ट इट? Yes, good evening to all of you. Screen is nothing showing. Guys, please confirm. Can you guys see my screen? Okay, thank you. Swati, there is some issue at your end. Please check it. Nothing, we are just starting. Okay, Raj is asking, I was not there yesterday. So tell me what is. We have completed, it is blank screen. Attendees view. I think my screen is visible. Okay, just check it now. Yesterday, I think we have completed two libraries, remaining part of the pandas and some part of matplotlib. Okay. And today we are going to start about the machine learning. I got some questions. Wait. Ashok is telling me I missed your last session. Okay, Ashok, you can go through the recordings available. Rajneesh is asking something, some correction in NumPy section in output section. Okay, Rajneesh, I'm checking. Okay, Rajneesh, I'm checking what's your issue. Import, here's a written some code, import NumPy, NumPy array, then sum of elements. Okay, and then sum of elements in y axis, transpose of axis. Similar thing we have written over the website, I think. Just a second. I'm opening my Jupyter notebook. Just wait, guys. Raj, we have done an pandas library and matplotlib library. Like NumPy and pandas introduction we have done day before this, and today we yesterday we have completed pandas like data frame slicing and missing value aggregate functions and started the matplotlib. Okay, why is not defined? Resnis, I'm checking your code. X is equal to array, and then sum of these. This y is not. And then I'm open the NumPy. This guy's wait, I'm solving a problem that like Resnis want, there is something wrong in the NumPy module. So I'm just checking. Wait a minute. One, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three, four, eight, nine. NP dot sum, NP dot this. Sum is 27, sum is 27, xx is 12 and 15, xx is 12 and 15, and then yx is 3, 7, 17. 3, 7, 17, then transpose 138, 249. Okay, transpose is wrong, right? Rajnis, I got, I think, okay, you have done the comment. Okay. There is the problem in the transpose, I think. Right, Rajnis? Okay, we will correct it. Thank you. Okay, and check my comment. Okay, I have done one time this and submitted. Ma'am, Chirag is saying, ma'am, I have submitted. Competition problem. Yes, Chirag, I have checked your problem and it is the correct answer. That is the good you have done. First thing, guys, I just before starting getting started, I just tell you, like yesterday I have given two problems in the practice and doubts. And only the 2 person in the class is replied to them. Like one is the Go EduHub's coding competition problem. This was our question and you need to solve this. So only the Chirag provided the answer, and then the one more, Manish has also written the answer. There is a little bit correction needed in the Manish solution, and Chirag's is working fine for all the test cases. So I advise you guys, rest of the guys also, please practice over this question. पहले आप लोग इस question को समझो कि क्या करना है आपको, and after that try to solve it. Yeah, Sagun, you have done today lots of comments. You have read all the topics in a single day. I checked your comments, some comments today. So okay, that is okay if you have done today. Okay, that is okay, no issue. Just write the small summary. एनीथिंग एल्स? आप लोगों ने ट्राई किया ये क्वेश्चन किस किस ने किया? प्लीज गिव मी सम कंफर्मेशन. हैव यू ट्राइड दिस क्वेश्चन? एक्सेस ट्राई किया था मैम एंड आयुष इज ऑल्सो यस. भूपेंद्र ट्राई वंस अगेन. Yeah, Swati replied another one, right? I checked another one also. Swati replied. And Chirag, one more request to you. Kindly explain the logic also here so that the some people who didn't get it, what is happening here, so they will easily reach it. Okay? So, Chirag, you just explain this, what you are doing here. इन्हें like comment करके आप इसको थोड़ा थोड़ा explain कर दो. जैसे आप लोग पढ़ते हो ना पाइथन के टॉपिक्स, इसमें कैसे एक्सप्लेन किया हुआ है, उसी तरह से आपको थोड़ा एक्सप्लेन करना है. ओके, राहुल इज आस्किंग मैम वेबसाइट ओपन नहीं हो रही थी. ऐसा नहीं है राहुल, आई थिंक वेबसाइट ओपन हो रही थी. मैंने मॉर्निंग में भी बैच लिया है, आफ्टरनून में भी बैच लिया, तो ऐसा नहीं था. सागर इज सॉल्व बट सबमिट नहीं किया. ओके, यू विल डू इट, नो इश्यू. आपने सॉल्व किया है तो हो सकता है आपकी अप्रोच अलग हो सकती है, चिराग की अप्रोच अलग हो सकती है. सबका अपना अपना वे होता है प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व करने का. सो आप लोग अपना जो भी प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व करते हैं, जो सोल्यूशन आता है, उसको नीचे कमेंट कर देना. सो अदर पर्सन कैन रिव्यू इट. हम लोग इसको चेक कर लेंगे. और जैसे चिराग ने सॉल्व किया, चिराग दूसरे सॉल्यूशन को चेक करेगा तो उसको पता लगेगा कि ही कैन इम्प्रूव हिज सॉल्यूशन और चिराग सॉल्यूशन इज बेटर देन अदर सॉल्यूशन. तो वो चीजें हम देखेंगे अपन. उसके बाद आपको भी एक जो अच्छा सॉल्यूशन है वो पता चलेगा कि किस तरह से हमें लॉजिकली चीजें सॉल्व करनी चाहिए. ओके, मनीष यू जस्ट रन योर कोड. और मैंने इसमें लॉजिक पूरा रीड नहीं किया, बट अगर मैं 4 पे टेस्ट करती हूँ ना इसको, सो इट इज प्रोवाइडिंग द रॉन्ग रिजल्ट. ये सारे टेस्ट केसेस इसमें पास नहीं हो रहे. एक बार आप दोबारा इसको चेक करना. ओके, सगुन इज आस्किंग मैम व्हेन विल यू अपलोड यस्टरडे लेक्चर. आफ्टर द हाफ एन आवर या 1 आवर आई थिंक यू विल फाइंड इट. ओके, सो नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द न्यू थिंग, दैट इज द फर्स्ट थिंग. फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन आई आस्क यू, व्हाट इज द मशीन लर्निंग? वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट नाउ मशीन लर्निंग. वी आर गुड इनफ विद द डेटा साइंस लाइब्रेरीज. वी कैन वर्क विद द डेटा साइंस लाइब्रेरीज एंड वी कैन प्रैक्टिस द मशीन लर्निंग एल्गोरिथम्स नाउ. ओके, एंड पुष्पेंद्र इज आस्किंग मैम वेयर वी कैन फाइंड द क्वेश्चंस. लाइक वन मोर टाइम गाइज, आई टेल यू देयर इज अ कैटेगरी प्रैक्टिस एंड डाउट्स. ओके, अंडर द कैटेगरी ट्रेनी इंटर्न्स आफ्टर द 15/04/2022/2020, इस पे आप क्लिक करेंगे तो आपको एक सब कैटेगरी मिलेगी यहाँ पे. एंड सब कैटेगरी के अंदर डाउट्स एंड प्रैक्टिस हैं. एंड चिराग, वन मोर क्वेश्चन, टू मोर क्वेश्चंस आई गिवन नाउ. आप जिन्होंने जो पहले दो क्वेश्चंस करे हैं उनको नेक्स्ट दो क्वेश्चंस अभी करने हैं. कोडिंग कॉम्पिटिशन प्रॉब्लम 2 and the one is simple Python program. Okay, so you guys need to complete these two questions also. And what about the deep copy and shallow copy? In this, Chirag, you have written very small. Okay, I got some more answers. You have written very small. Swati has given some examples. So explain with examples, that would be the better. Okay, guys. एंड लाइक आप लोग यहाँ पे जो भी पब्लिश कर रहे हो वो आपके नाम से पब्लिश हो रहा है, तो आप इसको बाद में कहीं पे शो भी करते हो तो एक अच्छा मोमेंट होगा आपके लिए कि आपने कंटेंट में पार्ट लिया था. So now you people please define what is the machine learning, right? अब आप लोग मुझे बताओगे मशीन लर्निंग क्या होता है बेसिकली. Today I'll tell you some theory part. After that we will go through the implementation. I got some answers. It is a subset of AI used to explore machine. Okay. I got this answer from Swati Saxena. Basically, guys, what is machine learning is we are training a machine with the help of data. Basically, we are training machine with the help of data. Answer is correct. Like it is a part of artificial intelligence. You can see the diagram that is in my system, like over the my screen. Artificial intelligence and machine learning is sub part of AI, and deep learning is sub part of machine learning. I got lots of definitions. One is from Kuldeep. Machine learning is an application of artificial intelligence that provides systems the ability to automatically learn and improve from experience without being explicitly programmed. Okay, and Daniel has written machine learning is a method to train a model to understand the future based on the previous data. And Sagar has written if then else in the decorated way. I didn't get it. And Vishal has written, it is a field of study, computer learning capabilities improving without use programmer. Okay, so guys, that is all are almost correct. We are near to the definition, and there are lots of ways to define the machine learning. Basically, you can say we are making a machine more efficient, just like the human being with the help of data, right? So basically, first of all, you should know what is the artificial intelligence, what is the machine learning, and what is the deep learning, right? You should clear about the confusion. Like it is not, some people always know I'm studying deep learning, I don't know artificial intelligence. Some people are telling like I'm studying machine learning, I don't know deep learning. So all are basically connected. And when you are studying a part, like if you are studying machine learning, it means you are studying automatically artificial intelligence. Okay. So, in the artificial intelligence, we are making the machine intelligent just like the human being. And as you know, human being is the best creature on the earth. We can think, we have brain, we can think the different, we can think in the different perspective. According to the situation, we can react, respond, but machine cannot. So we just try to make a machine just like the human being. So for that, what we need to do? Actually, we need to train the machine. And then how to train the machine? We train the machine with the help of data. Basically, अगर मैं अपनी लाइफ की बात करूं, what we people learn, basically we are learning from our environment, learning from our tutor, learning from our parents. Wherever you are go, you will learn something, right? So we are learning from the things, and we have mind, so we can easily learn the things with the help of some activities. But same thing we want in the machine. So to train the machine, we need some data. And we need to provide machine all the data. After that only the machine can learn the things. Okay. And here you can see like Artificial intelligence is a broad domain and machine learning is a subset of AI, and then deep learning is a subset of machine learning. And basically you can say deep learning uses the neural network. And this is the beautiful concept, guys. Neural network nowadays it is getting more focus because it follows the structure of our human brain. Basically we have neural system, we have neural network in our mind, our brain. Similarly, we are trying to construct a neural network in the machine. That is called the neural network. We are implementing neural network and we are using deep learning. It uses neural network to simulate human-like decision making, right? So basically we need to study the neural network if you want to go deep into the deep learning. Here we are limited to the machine learning. Just I'm telling the difference between the AI, machine learning, deep learning, and then we will implement some algorithms of the machine learning, right? But first you need to clear about this. The history of artificial intelligence, like most of you already know, AI is very old field. You cannot say it is the new field, but people nowadays talking about AI is more. Why? Because we have lots of resources, we have lots of data, and like with the help of these two things, we can implement different algorithms. We can make machines smart. We can train the machine because we have lots of data. We have good machines. We have normal machine, CPUs, GPUs, and TPUs, right? So basically, it is a very old field, and the AI was came into the existence first in the 1956. But within the last 2-3 years, it was more famous, and now everybody wants to implement the AI in any way. Like some organizations, like every organization want to implement the AI in some way, like in their customer analysis, their product analysis, or some want to generate some smart machines like that. And why this concept came into the existence? Basically, the in the 2016, Google first time created a program that is called the AlphaGo that plays the Go game, and that program was a combination of neural network and algorithms, and they held a competition between the AlphaGo program and the champion of the Go game. So first time AlphaGo game won by 4-1. And after that, the people thought that a program can beat a human being, a champion. So we can develop more programs like this. And they started to work over that, and they modified this program moreover. And again, in the 2017, they held a competition in China. And that time, AlphaGo won by 3-0. So basically, after that, they started to work over the field of AI, or basically in the neural network, and started to work in all the complex field, complex problems in the world. Okay, so you know that why AI is we can implement easily nowadays, because we have good processing power, we have good data. So it is very easy to implement AI nowadays. And what is the AI? You know, artificial intelligence. I'm going through very quickly. AI is a technique which enables machines to mimic human behavior. We are making the machine just like the human being, right? And why AI is more famous? Because we have shortage of. I have taken a scenario like we want to make a machine just like a doctor. Then how do you make a machine just like doctor? You need to feed the machine lots of records of the patients. In that we mention like symptoms of a disease and a particular disease name. So basically in the machine learning, we need lots of data, and in that data we have some part of symptoms. Like here in the case of this, we have some part of symptoms and we have some final disease. So if you can say the symptoms are here referred to as a features. Basically, like aap ek machine ko train karana chahte hain. Ab aapko machine ko learn karana hai ki it is a dog or cat. Theek hai? आपके पास एक डॉग है एक कैट है, यू कैन रिकॉग्नाइज डॉग एंड कैट इजिली, इज इट अ डॉग और इज इट अ कैट इजिली, राइट। लाइक हम एक छोटे बच्चे को ट्रेन करते हैं तो उसको हम दो बार बताते हैं, चार बार बताते हैं, आफ्टर दैट ही और सी कैन लर्न, आफ्टर दैट ही कैन सी इजिली टेल यू इट इज अ डॉग इट इज अ कैट। हाउ? बिकॉज दे गेट सम फीचर्स फ्रॉम दैट पर्टिकुलर ऑब्जेक्ट एंड दे लर्न दैट। सिमिलरली अगर मुझे मशीन को ट्रेन कराना है, सो मैं मशीन में एक डेटा, पहले डेटा चाहिए होगा। डेटा कैसे बनाएंगे हम उसके फीचर्स का? लाइक आप एक सिंपल सा एग्जाम्पल लेते हैं, आप एक्सेल या डॉग कोई फाइल बनाते हैं जिसमें आप कैट के सारे फीचर्स लिखेंगे, फिर उसके आगे क्लास लिखेंगे कि ये कैट है। आपने 10 फीचर्स लिखे, उसके हाइट, कलर, शेप, ओरिएंटेशन, बहुत सारी चीजें आपने लिखी, और उसके आगे आपने क्लास लिखी कैट। सो दीज 10 थिंग्स आर द फीचर्स ऑफ पर्टिकुलर ऑब्जेक्ट एंड द कैट इज ए क्लास ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर ऑब्जेक्ट, कि वो क्या है, लेबल, यू कैन से लेबल। इस तरह से आपको बहुत सारे कैट्स के फीचर कलेक्ट करने पड़ेंगे, एंड ये मैनुअल प्रोसेस होती है फीचर कलेक्ट करने की। ये बहुत लेंदी प्रोसेस होती है जिसमें आपको कितनी सारी ब्रीड्स हैं, इसमें डिफिकल्टीज आती हैं, बिकॉज हर एक पर्सन का परस्पेक्टिव डिफरेंट होता है। यू हैव डिफरेंट परस्पेक्टिव, आई हैव डिफरेंट परस्पेक्टिव टू रिकग्नाइज कैट एंड डॉग। सो बेसिकली वॉट वी आर डूइंग, वी आर कलेक्टिंग द फीचर्स एंड देन वी आर फाइनली वी आर राइटिंग इज इट अ कैट और डॉग, and that data we need to feed to the machine, right? So similarly in the expert doctor also we need to collect the data of a particular symptoms of a disease, and then like 10 symptoms of diabetes, and then the name of the disease is diabetes. Similarly a blood pressure or other disease, we need to have millions of records of like 10 disease. If you want to train for the 10 disease, you need to collect the data for the 10 diseases, different patients. Just a sec. So we have collected data for the different diseases, and then we feed the data to that algorithm. And basically, algorithm will learn from that data. This is the traditional way of feature extracting. We manually extracting feature, and it takes even months to collect the feature, and we are not sure we captured the perfect features. Okay, so simply what we basically need, we need some features and labels of the data, right? And what is the benefit of AI? In AI, like if you train the model, आपने किसी मॉडल को ट्रेन कर दिया, देन दैट मॉडल कैन वर्क एफिशिएंटली विद द सेम एफिशिएंसी 24/7 एंड इट हैव हाई कंप्यूटेशनल पावर। ह्यूमन हैव लिमिटेड वर्किंग कैपेसिटी, राइट? एंड मशीन लर्निंग, यू कैन, दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द एआई, द डेफिनेशन ऑफ एआई, एंड नाउ कम टू द मशीन लर्निंग। मशीन लर्निंग इज अ ब्रांच ऑफ आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस दैट कम्स अंडर द category of AI, and it concerns the construction and study of systems that can learn from data, right? This is the simple definition I have taken from the Wikipedia. There are lots of definitions available, but main thing is we are training the machine with the help of data, right? Here I have taken a simple analogy, like if you want to buy the some mangoes, you will go to the some supermarket, and then you will choose according to your learning. So you know certain rules, like you know which mangoes are more sweet, which mangoes are more sour, which mangoes are more juicy. So you know certain features, certain properties according to your learning, according to your understanding. And similar thing, if you want to make a machine just like, you need to feed that certain rules, right? Data with the certain rules. Mansi, just wait, I'll come to your question. It is not to ask here this question. I'll parking a question right now. I'll answer it later. Okay. Just first understand the concepts. After that, I have given the difference between the traditional programming and machine learning. Basically, what is the traditional programming? In the traditional programming, we I have given a problem in Python to you. What you people done, you have some data, you developed a program in the system, you tested over the some data, and then you got some output, right? But in the machine learning, what we will do, we don't have any program, right? Simply, we have some data and some output. Using that data and output, we develop some algorithm, and that algorithm is basically our output. That program is basically our output, right? So I think you got now difference between the traditional programming and machine learning. And this is the normal definition I'm skipping. And you can say machine learning is about predicting the future based on the past. This is very precise definition. Machine learning is about to predicting the future based on the past, right? How we can do this? We have, there are certain rules to develop before develop a machine learning algorithm. You should know, like you have some data set, right? You will get some data set, and then what you need to do first? First, you need to divide that data set into two parts. One is training data, and another one is testing data, right? You have 500 records of data, then you need to divide that data in some part like 80-20 ratio, or 75-25 ratio, or 70-30 ratio. Some kind of this. Like in that, our 80% data will be training data and 20% data will be testing data. Why we do this? Basically, if you want to train a model, first you will tell the model what is the features and what will be the output, right? You train the model with the, you have 100 records, you train the model with the 80 records, okay? 80 features and output, you train the model. Now you want to check, is my model now working perfect or not? So for that, what I need to do, I need to keep some testing data, because we need to provide the data similar to data which we have trained. Like maine aapko machine learning train karaya, aapko machine learning mein padha rahi hu. Agar main machine learning ka hi koi question puchungi to hi aap answer de payenge. Main aapko ek compiler ka question puchungi to aap answer nahi de payenge na. सो सिमिलरली हम लोग क्या करेंगे, डेटा भी हमको उसी तरह के डेटा से ट्रेन कराया है, काइंड ऑफ डेटा से ही हमें उसको टेस्ट करना है, राइट? हम लोग जैसा डेटा उसको ट्रेन करा रहे हैं वैसा ही कुछ सैंपल डेटा रखेंगे, उससे हम टेस्ट करेंगे एंड वी विल चेक एक्यूरेसी ऑफ आवर मॉडल. ओके, सो सिंपली विल ट्रेन द मॉडल विद द हेल्प ऑफ सम डेटा एंड मॉडल विल बी क्रिएटेड, और यू कैन से ए प्रिडिक्टर विल बी क्रिएटेड. After that, we will use our testing data and we will predict our future. Right? Here you can see the process, how it is happening. Basically, initially you have data, you created data, or you have you get data from some source. So basically, you need to divide the data in two parts. One part is training data. Okay, and another part is testing data. Here we have training data. At the training data, we used to train the ML algorithm. We created a model, and that data we feed it to the model, and at the end we got a ML algorithm. We got a machine learning algorithm. Okay, then what we have done, we got new data, new input data, or you can say we have some testing data. You will feed that data, and you will feed that data to the algorithm, and this will predict your output. Okay, and what we will check, if it is giving the correct output as per expectation, then our model is perfect. Otherwise, we can say it is not a perfect model, and we will train again. Okay, here if it will give you the success results perfectly, we will check to the different data set, check to the more data, and then check accuracy according to the output. And if it is giving like 90% accuracy, 95% accuracy, then we can say our model is perfect and it is providing the 90% correct result. Otherwise, we need to train it again. Okay, so this is the basically process of machine learning. There are different kind of machine learning. One is supervised, unsupervised, and reinforced learning, right? There are three types of, broadly we can categorize three types of machine learning. There are, you can also see semi-supervised and something else types. But broadly we can say there are three types of machine learning. One is supervised, unsupervised, and reinforced, okay? In our course curriculum, there are the we will take two algorithms. One is supervised and one is unsupervised. We are limited to the course. We need to complete that in the 10 days. So we have in this curriculum included the two algorithms. Okay, one of the supervised and one of the unsupervised. And rest of the you can practice by yourself. So what is the basically supervised learning? Supervised learning is we have different, like here I have taken a simple example related to our day-to-day life. We have some fruits, like I have given a basket of fruits that have different kind of fruits like apple, orange, banana, mango, something like that. And it have label data. Label data means in your basket, if you have apple, then there is a label over that apple written as apple. Or the banana written as a banana. This is simply, I can say, label data. Or in the form of the machine learning, I can say I have a data seed in that I have features of apple and then the label is like apple. Then again, there is like 10 apples. I have features of each apple and then label is apple. Right? Similarly, I have features of banana and then label is banana. I got some questions. Just guys, wait. I'll answer your questions. Because it will break my flow. That's why I'm telling you. And supervised has structured data. No, nothing like the structured data. It is basically we have some features and then some label. Label means output we need to provide to the algorithm. Like if you have a feature of a particular object, then you need to tell what this object. Okay? Like आप train कर रहे हो, आप छोटे baby को train कर रहे हो, आप क्या करते हो? उसको apple देते हो और उसको बताते हो ये apple है. Banana देते हो, उसको बताते हो ये banana. इस तरह से आपने पांच different apple उसको दिए हैं. और आपने बार बार बताया इट इज एप्पल एप्पल बनाना बनाना ऑरेंज समथिंग लाइक दिस. आफ्टर दैट यू हैव प्रोवाइडेड अ सेपरेट एप्पल एंड यू आस्क्ड हिम व्हाट इज दिस, तो वो आपको एक लेबल बताएगा. अब आपने अगर उसको पहले बताया ही नहीं कि ये एप्पल है, उसने पहले कभी देखा ही नहीं कि ये एप्पल है, देन हाउ कैन ही और सी कैन रिकॉग्नाइज. ओके, सो बेसिकली इन द सुपरवाइज लर्निंग वी ट्रेन with the help of data. In that data we have some features and some label. Here the new terms introduced like features and label. And in the machine learning I introduced two three terms like training data, testing data, ML algorithm, then we calculate some accuracy. We are coming one to one. Kuch cheeze aapko bhi samajh aa rahi honge, kuch aap practical karenge to samajh aa jayegi. Okay, and we'll feed that data, then it will create some model or predictor, right? After that you can predict the label. And then they come to the another, this is the supervised learning, right? There is the different type of supervised learning. One type is called the classification. Okay, in the classification we have finite set of labels. Like we have in the basket, we have 100 fruits, but we can say we have four different types of fruits, like 100 fruits, but unique four fruits. So there are the four classes we can say. So it is the finite set of labels, right? हमारे पास इतने यूनिक लेबल हैं, यानी कि आपके पास 20 एप्पल हैं, 30 ऑरेंज हैं, 10 मैंगो हैं और 40 आपके पास बनाना है. देन यू कैन से देयर आर द फोर यूनिक क्लासेस. वी हैव फाइनाइट सेट ऑफ क्लासेस और लेबल्स, राइट? हियर आई हैव टेकन अनदर एग्जांपल. यू कैन सी द डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन द लो रिस्क एंड हाई रिस्क. व्हाट इज द लो रिस्क एंड हाई रिस्क? Basically, here I'm trying to tell you what is the feature and label. Like here, feature is this is the like income or savings. I have two features on the basis that I'm classifying in two categories. Like jinki income kam hai or saving bhi kam hai, then I can say this point, this will fall under the category of high risk. If you will prepare some data, something like this. A first column should be income, then second column should be saving, and third column should be category. Like for this point, I can say it is the 50,000 sal income and 10,000 saving, and then category should be high risk. Similarly, for each point, I will write the three things. One is income, saving, and then category. So at the end, you can see there would be the two unique categories. One is high risk, one is low risk. And we have features like income or savings. Okay, guys. Now I am coming to your questions. Okay, Ganesh is written. Sorry, ma'am, I had lost internet connection. No issue, Ganesh. And Anjali is asking, ma'am, its PPT is available on the website. No, Anjali. And something, guys, please learn. It is nothing like provide each and everything to you. You just want the spoon feeding, like you want only each and everything from me. Just learn something, no? I'm telling you, just focus on the class. Okay? I heard that we see accuracy of model. So how to calculate accuracy? Mansi is asking. Mansi, I'll tell you that how to calculate the accuracy. Okay? And there are the certain applications of the classification like face recognition, character recognition, spam detection, medical diagnosis, and biometric recognition. All these are the applications of classification. In those, what we have certain features, and then we have certain output classes. Like if you want to do one project is face recognition, okay? That we can implement with the help of deep learning. Like face recognition, here we have lots of data set. हम लोगों को face recognition करना. Basically क्या होता है face recognition? एक part आप करते हो face detection. Face detection कोई बड़ी चीज नहीं है, वो easily आप कर सकते हो. But when you come to the face recognition, what you need to do like you need to capture the feature of each and every person. Like मैं पांच लोगों का डेटा सेट मैंने लिया, मैं हर पर्सन की एटलीस्ट 50 या 60 इमेजेस स्टोर कराऊंगी ऑफ द फेस ओनली, एंड उससे मैं फीचर्स एक्सट्रैक्ट करूंगी, एंड देन मैं अपने मॉडल को ट्रेन करूंगी. एंड जब मैं लाइक आई एम टेकिंग इमेज ऑफ शुभम, सो शुभम की जब मैं 50 इमेजेस लेती हूँ तो उसके हर इमेज पे लेबल क्या दूंगी मैं? शुभम. बिकॉज जब वो लर्न करता है तो एक फीचर्स होता है उसके पास कैटेगरी, एक उसके पास कैटेगरी लेबल होता है. अगर आपने उसको लेबल ट्रेन नहीं कराया तो आप 50 इमेजेस किसी और की दोगे, लाइक एक्से की आपने 50 इमेजेस दी. सो शुभम और एक्से में वो कैसे डिस्टिंग्विश करेगा, वो कैसे नाम बताएगा आपको? सो बेसिकली आपको फीचर्स और लेबल दोनों प्रोवाइड कराने होते हैं, राइट? एंड मोर ओवर लाइक इनिशियल स्टेज इन द मशीन लर्निंग, हियर लाइक वी विल प्रैक्टिस ओवर द सिंपल एक्सेल डेटा. आफ्टर दैट वी मूव you can do in the deep learning like walk over the images. जिसमें हम इमेज से डेटा कैप्चर करते हैं, हम लाइव फेस रिकॉग्निशन कर सकते हैं. ऐसे कुछ चीजें मैं एक एग्जाम्पल बता रही हूँ आपको, इस तरह की चीजें आप इम्प्लीमेंट कर सकते हैं. सिंपली करेक्टर रिकॉग्निशन, ये भी एक क्लासिफिकेशन का एग्जाम्पल होता है. and spam detection, medical diagnosis, biometric recognition, these kind of things you can implement with the help of classification. But simply, when I talk about the some image kind of data, then we always refer to deep learning. Further on, I'll tell the difference between the deep learning and machine learning also. Just wait. Safa, if we give more labels, will accuracy be more? No. And more labels, not. It means like more data set. If you have more data set, then obviously accuracy will improve. Okay. And Swati is asking, what is regression? Swati, I'll tell it when we will implement the regression. Basically, you will got it. I'll just explain now also a little bit. Okay. Basically, one thing is classification. One part of machine supervised machine learning is classification. And another part is regression. What is basically regression? Regression is a real value. In this, we predict a numerical value. Like classification, mein hum log kya predict kar rahe the? Hum log ek label predict kar rahe the. Either apple, banana, orange. I'm talking in respect to my example. Okay? Like we were predicting the label, simple apple, orange, banana, something like this. But in case of regression, what we will predict? We will predict some real value, some numerical value. We use regression in the cases where we want some numerical value in the prediction. Just like stock price prediction, where you want some numerical value prediction, not a category. Okay? Value can be anything. We cannot limit to a value, but in a range. Right? You got it, regression, I think now. And इससे ज़्यादा अपन example करेंगे तो ज़्यादा अच्छे से clear हो जाए. And the, like here is an example of regression. This is a linear regression. Basically, in the regression, what we have here, we have some features here. Like x-axis, I have features. Y-axis, I have prediction. Okay. So it works just like the line, like it works just like the equation of line. Here I have written an equation of line, like y is equal to wx plus w naught. You can relate it with mathematical line equation, y is equal to mx plus c. Basically, what is the m, what is the x, and what is the c? Here just understand it. What happened, Swati? Swati is asking some questions. What is regression? Ma'am, it depends on the data, whether it should classification or regression. Yes, Swati, it should depend on the data, what you want, regression or classification. And ma'am, it's depend on the data, whether it should be classification or regression. Ma'am, it depends on the data. Same question. Okay, Swati. It depends on the your prediction. आपको क्या चाहिए? आपको एक numerical value चाहिए prediction में या you want a class? Okay? So basically इसमें हमें एक numerical value output में मिलती है. ये एक line की equation पे चलता है. कैसे चलता है? अभी मैं आपको बताती हूँ. Like आपने एक linear regression की एक हमने equation यहाँ लिखी. Y is equal to mx plus c. आप जानते हैं सब. So basically यहाँ पे m क्या होता है? M is the slope or orientation of the line, you can say. And c we define the position of the line, like की intercept part जो आपका होता है. Intercept, Daniel is given the answer also. Yes, Daniel, that is the correct. Intercept part की वो y axis पे कितना lie कर रहा है, कि यहाँ से start हो रहा है, यहाँ से start हो रहा है, या कहाँ से start हो रहा है, right? And m is your slope line, is there a positive and negative, a kis tarah ka slope aapka, right? Ab yahan pe line se kya meaning hai? Basically aapka ek value hai x, theek hai, aapka ek feature hai. Ab aap uske basis pe aapne ek point draw kiya, theek hai, like mileage itna hai to price kitni honi chahiye. Yahan pe is ek is cross ko hum samajhte hain, theek hai. This cross I'm taking a highlighter, just wait. like this cross I want to understand. Okay, so what is this? Here there is some mileage value, and corresponding to it we have some price value. So mileage is a feature and price is a actual price of this according to this mileage price of the car. But our line, what our line says, our line is like this. It means what our model is predicted is something here. Like when you take this mileage, then it will predict a value lies here. The price would be this. Then what is the difference between the actual price and a predicted price? This difference, this is the difference between, just a second. I'm taking the pen. So here, this is the mileage. According to this mileage, we have some price, right? And we have predicted something here. Okay. So what is the difference? This is the difference between the prediction and actual value. Meanwhile, I got a question. Shruti is asking y is equal to wx plus w naught. Here you can relate w is a in m and w naught is c. Okay. These are the weights. It is the basic mathematics. Y is equal to mx plus c. Applying ka equation jab likhte hain, to m aapka slope hota hai. Okay. So here I was telling like what it is predicted, what should be predicted and what is predicted. Ab hum is difference ko nikalenge. Hum ye jo line draw karte hain, ye hum best fit line hoti hai hamari. Okay, little bit mathematics, it's not as much mathematics. Swati is written, we should read the mathematics regression. This is very simple, and aapko ek choti si line ki equation samajhni hai, baaki kuch bhi nahi hai. Simply hum isme kuch basically yahan pe hamare paas ek x hai aur ek y hai. X kya aapka, x aapka independent variable hai. कुछ वैल्यूज आप एक्स के रखोगे. इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल से मीनिंग यहाँ पे क्या है, कुछ फीचर्स जो किसी पे डिपेंड नहीं कर रहे. फीचर्स डजंट डिपेंड ऑन एनीथिंग. सो बेसिकली वी हैव सम फीचर्स एंड हियर वी हैव माइलेज फीचर. ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दिस फीचर वी विल प्रिडिक्ट सम वैल्यू, लाइक वी विल प्रिडिक्ट प्राइस ऑफ द कार. सो X we can say independent variable and Y is dependent on the X. So Y is our dependent variable here. So Y हमारा जो prediction से आएगा वो, X is our independent variable and Y is our dependent variable. Ganesh is asking, entire video of machine learning is available in YouTube now. After the class, it will be available. Okay? You are not getting now. Okay? So basically, x is independent variable and y is dependent variable. You have x, you need to predict y. You need to set w and w naught like that so that we will get the best fit line. राइट हमको W एंड W नॉट को इस तरह से एडजस्ट करना है कि हम लोगों को बेस्ट फिट लाइन मिले. ऐसा नहीं कि हमारी लाइन यहाँ कहीं जा रही है. मेरी ड्राइंग अच्छी नहीं है. लाइक ऐसे हमारी लाइन कहीं जा रही है, ऐसा कुछ नहीं है. लाइन हमें ऐसी चाहिए जो हमारे पॉइंट्स में बेस्ट फिट करे. राइट या दिस इज रिग्रेशन इज ए algorithm of machine learning. It is a type of supervised machine learning. You can say this is the basic of the machine learning. First algorithm, when we learn machine learning, we should know the regression. Kapil is asking, can we do some practical? Theory boring ho raha hai mom. We will do practical, but first you should know the concept, otherwise you cannot get the practical. पहले आपको कंसेप्ट समझा रही हूं मैं, उसके बाद हम प्रैक्टिकल करेंगे. ओके okay? What about the rest of the guys? Are you getting the things? Or shall I need to change? Give me a quick confirmation. Okay, I got lots of confirmation. Thank you, thank you. I'm telling in very short, Raj. Okay. Second, just focus on the concept part. You should learn this. Otherwise, you cannot get the things. Udithanshu, what types of algorithms should be used for the regression? Like if you want to predict the stock price or some other projects also, I'll tell you. You have, Man says, even this we have in academic. Okay, that is good. But some guys don't have in academic. That's why I need to explain this. Okay. And if you already know, that is well and good. It would be revision 4. Okay, so simply we have x, y, and we will predict the y. Okay, guys. So I'm leaving this. Now come to the next thing. Regression applications, which type of application you can use in the regression, like using the regression algorithm, you can predict. One, I already told you, predict the value of the stock price. And if you want to predict the navigation, like car, plane navigation, angle of the steering wheel and acceleration, all these things you can predict with the help of regression. In these, we are predicting a numerical value. Similarly, whether over the time you want to predict the temporal trends, then also you need to implement regression. Okay. Ranking is also part of this. Now come to the second type of machine learning, that is the unsupervised machine learning. Okay, guys. And that I'll tell after the like completion of the machine learning. So I do not need to tell now. When we will do the practical, usi time mein aapko bata dunga. Okay. Now come to the deep learning basically. What is the deep learning? You should know the difference, right? Deep learning is basically a particular type of machine learning that is inspired by the functionality of our brain cells called neurons. Lead to the concept of artificial neural. As I already told you, it is a type of machine learning, but it is inspired by the functionality of our brain cells. Like we have neurons, we have neural network. Similarly, we will create an artificial neural network in deep learning. Okay. What is the difference between the deep learning and machine learning? Basically, in the deep learning, we skip the manual step of extracting features. You can directly feed images to algorithm and then we can predict the objects. Basically, जो मैंने आपको अभी तक बताया कि हम लोग फीचर एक्सट्रैक्ट कैसे करते हैं मशीन लर्निंग में हम मैनुअली फीचर एक्सट्रैक्ट करते हैं बट इन केस ऑफ डीप लर्निंग वॉट वी विल डू feature extraction automatically with the help of some algorithms. Okay, so ये हमारा time save करता है and हम जब images और videos पे work करते हैं तो ये ज़्यादा efficient होता है because एक simple image में lakhs of features होते हैं that is not possible to capture by a human being. Okay, so basically you can see here I have taken an example of deep learning. Simply like यहाँ पे मैंने आपको ये एक example क्यों लिया है? इसमें मैं आपको ये दिखाना चाह रही थी क्या-क्या features होते हैं और क्या object होता है. Basically आप इसको देखते ही आपके दिमाग में एक question आना चाहिए. What is this? Then you will answer me. It is a square, right? Then how you did recognize it? Basically, you know, it have four sides, it is closed, all are perpendicular and equal sides. So these four basic features you should know. Then only you can classify it is a square or rectangle or something else, right? Similarly, आप कोई भी algorithm implement करते हैं तो आपको जो basic features होते हैं वो पता होने चाहिए. वो features आपको निकालने पड़ते हैं पहले, उसके बाद ही आप algorithm implement करते हैं. Right? Okay, so basically this is the simple fundamentals of the how a particular object have features and what the label of the feature object. And in the deep learning, these things will be implemented by using some neural network algorithms. Okay, so वहाँ पे आपको जो ये features निकालने की manual process है वो eliminate हो जाती है और वहाँ अपन पूरा neural network use करते हैं. Neural network क्या होता है guys? Basically, neural network में हमारे पास inputs होते हैं. Inputs क्या होते हैं? Directly image या जो object है वो directly हम feed करते हैं और न्यूरल नेटवर्क में कई लेयर्स होती है. एक इनपुट लेयर होती है, आउटपुट लेयर होती है, हिडन लेयर होती है, एक्टिवेशन फंक्शंस होते हैं, न्यूरॉन्स होते हैं. इस तरह से आपके पास बहुत सारी चीजें होती हैं. सो जैसे मैंने यहाँ रफली एक डायग्राम आपको दिखाया है कि आपके पास कोई इमेज है, इनपुट्स हैं, देन न्यूरॉन्स उसमें से पास करेंगे और फाइनली आपके पास एक आउटपुट लेयर. स्ट्रक्चर अभी आपको समझ नहीं आएगा इसलिए मैं स्किप कर रही हूँ. Okay, and you, I think you already know some applications of artificial intelligence, machine learning, and deep learning. I'm just passing through that. First application you can say you are using the Google Maps, and then auto friend tagging, then alt tags, and these are the food delivery and cabs you are using. They are using the concept of machine learning, deep learning, and ad recommendations. And virtual personal assistants you are using is speech recognition, speech to text conversion, natural language processing, text to speech conversion. All these things we are using. These are the some example of AI, right? And this is the beautiful application of AI is the driverless cars, right? Amazon, Naman is written a question. Gmail spam is also an application. Yes, Naman. And Amazon Go, all these are the application of AI. Basically, they are using the AI. They are using AI to enhance their business or in some other way. And as I told you, the driverless cars, some of my students also done the hands-on over this project. You can go to our website and you can check the student reviews. Like last to last year summer intensive students done this project under me, and they have we have tried to implement a self-driving car. It is not like a robotics car, it is a self-driving car that is just like how to it take automatically decision based on the neural network. You can go to our website and there is the reviews tab and you can see the reviews of the previous students and what kind of projects they developed under last and last to last year. And they have developed some projects at our training center. So if you want to go ahead, you can develop kind of projects. Okay. Now come to our topic. I was telling you. And Netflix is also using and some other applications you can see like fraud detection, Google Translate, dynamic pricing, search engines, image MRI, image analysis, scene classification, handwriting recognition. All these things you can implement when you will complete some part of AI ML deep learning. Okay. And as I told you, deep learning will eliminate the step of manual feature extracting. And where should you opt the deep learning and where should you opt for the machine learning? It is up to you. It is depends on the what amount of data you have. If you have huge amount of data, then you should opt for the deep learning. And if you have less data, then you should go with the older learning algorithms. Okay? बिकॉज ऐसा क्यों किया हमने, बिकॉज जब आपके पास डेटा ज्यादा होता है तो आप मशीन लर्निंग में आप उसको हैंडल करने में थोड़ा डिफिकल्टी होती है, बट न्यूरल नेटवर्क में आप उसको इजिली हैंडल कर लेते हैं. एंड फॉर द डीप लर्निंग यू नीड अ गुड प्रोसेसिंग पावर. एट द स्टूडेंट लेवल यू कैन वर्क ओवर द योर नॉर्मल मशीन, बट वेन वी इम्प्लीमेंट इन द रियल टाइम इन द इंडस्ट्री इन द प्रोडक्शन, then we should need good GPUs to implement deep learning. And this is the process of how to feature engineering we do in the deep learning. Simply, we feed some images and then it will extract through the neural network, it will extract some contrast patterns and then it will get some features. It will learn in each layer some part and then at the end it will get output. Okay guys, so now I can summarize these three terms: machine learning, deep learning and AI. AI you already know, to create a machine just like the human being. And in the machine learning, we are feeding the machine with the data and getting the some good predictor. And in deep learning, we are using the neural network, and with the help of neural network we are trying to make a machine just like a human decision making. Okay, so it was little bit boring, but guys, you should know all these concepts. बाकी मैं थ्योरी बहुत कम लेती हूँ, but you should know the concepts. Otherwise, if somebody asks you a question, you cannot answer that. You do not know the concepts. You do not know the basic difference between the things. What is the machine learning? What is the deep learning? What is the AI? Why you are using? What algorithm falls under the category of ML, under the category of deep learning? You should know all these things. Okay, so that's all about the theoretical part, and after that we'll implement some part of the machine learning, post algorithm of the machine learning. Now come to our website. Okay guys, just tell me, how was this? You are sleeping or listening to me? Okay, great, amazing, listening. And Kapil is sleeping. Kapil, you should listen it, because it is very important for your purpose. And Krishna is awesome, great. Anjali is writing. Okay, so it was basically concepts you should know. And now we will implement the things. Okay, and I'm coming to the topics. Now come to this machine supervised ML introduction. Sagar has written, difficult to understand but too interesting to keep me on. Thank you Sagar, thank you all. Okay guys, and now come to our article, supervised learning. There is, I got a question, just wait and read it. Ma'am, please done for today, Pushpinder. Daniel has written, it was good to understand. I read the concepts many times but could not understand the basics. But now it is clear to me. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Daniel. It's our pleasure. Okay, Pushpinder, just a little bit we need to do now. Just come to the website on supervised learning and machine learning. You first need to read these things. I think most of the things I have covered. This is very simple, linear regression. Okay, so linear regression aapko thoda sa padhna hai, isko padh kar aana hai. Implement hum kal kar lenge. I understand today's lots of things you got. Okay, and you need to understand, you need to read this part, supervised machine learning. And if you one thing we left, I got a question from Sagar. sky pie. Raj is written sky pie. Sky pie is basically, I'll tell you sky pie, just wait. It is very little library and we don't need as much sky pie in the machine learning. Simply, I'll show you one example here. Sky pie is basically to implement the mathematical problems, like if you want to calculate the interpolation, integration, and like some signal processing, optimize the things. For that, we have lots of functions available in the SkyPy. So for the scientific calculations or mathematical calculations, we have some functions like you want to calculate the fast Fourier transform, Fourier transform. So there are functions available. You can use that functions and implement the SkyPy. So here simply you can see the example. We have written an example like from SkyPy import linALG, linear algebra. We are importing all the functions of linear algebra here. So you can use the functions defined inside the linear algebra. Like we also imported here the NumPy and then created a NumPy array and you can calculate the determinant of array. Like I can show you, I can run it. Okay, so simply here what we are doing, we declared an array, then we are finding a determinant of array, then we again declared an array, we're finding the inverse of array. And then at the end, we are reshaping the array, and then we find it the diagonal, and then added to array A plus B and printed the C. So, simple calculations like mathematical calculation you can do with the help of some already available functions in this SkyPy. Okay. Am I audible? Pushpender is written. Okay, guys. So come to our curriculum. So till this topic we have completed, okay? And I just want to tell you one simple Python because implementation of supervised linear is will take some time. इसके लिए हमें एक पूरी क्लास चाहिए. सो मैं इसको अभी टच नहीं कर रही हूँ. ओके, आई एम नॉट टचिंग दिस टॉपिक बिकॉज इट नीड द कंप्लीट क्लास. ओके, अदरवाइज यू वॉन्ट गेट इस टुमारो. सो नाउ आई एम पिकिंग ए वन टॉपिक ऑफ पाइथन दैट वी विल डू टुडे. ओके, so we left it till the functions. Now I can tell you about the exception handling, or I can tell you classes and objects. This is the pretty independent topic. Yes, class and objects. What is basically class and objects? So here we will understand and we will do this. We get the some examples, simple examples we have written. Okay. So simply just come to this, guys. What is class? Basically, if you have studied, oops, like C++ or Java, then it is the same as in the Python. We have some classes. Class is basically a blueprint or template from which specific objects are created. Basically एक simple एक blueprint किसी भी चीज का एक sketch होता है. An object is, we create an object of that class and we access all the properties, all the data types, all the functions of the class through the function. Like class having some things inside it, and we can access that variables and functions with the help of objects only. Okay, simply we define a class using keyword class. Here we have a inbuilt keyword called class, and variables in the class behave like attributes, right? And attributes are always accessed using dot. Like when you declare an object, you want to access some attributes from the class, and then you can access, like you have a class A and you declared an object of class A is A1. If you want to access a function of class A through the A1, then you need to access A1 dot function name or variable. हम example देखते हैं अभी, don't worry about it. To understand the concept of class and objects, we can think of class as a sketch of a house. It contains all the details about the floors, doors, windows, etc. Based on these description, we build the house, and house is object. House blueprint is class, right? So now the class variable is variable that is shared by all the different objects, instances of the class. Like I'll draw. I have a class. This is a class, and I have certain objects, object one, object two, like this. And there are certain things inside the class. So like some class variables, we can say variables. I'm writing here on instance variables. Okay, IV. Instance of objects लिख रही हूँ. So here class variable is variable that is shared by all the different objects. Basically, when you declare a class variable, it means it will create an object, and that object will be shared by all the objects, all the reference variable that we use in the object. Basically, सारे object उस एक variable को share करते हैं. And then the instance object variables are the variable which are unique to each instance. Instance means objects. And the objects के अंदर variable होते हैं, वो हर object के unique होते हैं. Simple concept है guys. It is defined inside a method or belongs only to the current instance of the class. Basically, an object is everything we can see around. For example, a person is an object of human class, right? Methods are also called as a function. Methods function एक ही बात है. And then we are which are defined in a class and describes the behavior of a object. So basically, we create a class, like we are using the inbuilt keyword class, and then we give some name of the class, and then colon, and then we write the some statements. Okay. The pass statement, when we want to pass, we want to keep the empty class, then we can use the pass statement जो हमने loop में भी किया था, right? Syntax of the object is simply object name is equal to class name dot arguments. Like here we have taken an example, you can understand from here. Like we have created a class called employee, okay, colon. Then inside this, we have variable 1, variable 2, variable 3. And we have certain functions like def. How to define a function? You already know def function name. And inside the function, we need to pass it. If you are declaring a function inside a class, one parameter that is always present is called the self. Okay. So this is a function fun. And inside it, we have one argument that is the self and colon, and then there are the two statements inside it. Okay. Now we are creating objects for the class. What is the name of the class? Employee. So E1 is equal to employee and then bracket. This is the method to create the objects for the class in Python. Okay, simply we are creating object E1 and object E2 of the class employee. This is the employee class and this is the E1 and this is the E2. Okay guys, hum do object create kar rahe hain employee class ke. And this is the method, jaise java mein hum new karke likhte hain, yahan pe hame new karke likhne ki zarurat hai. Raj is asking a question, ma'am def function self nahi samajh aaya. Just wait Raj, I'm coming to it again. And what we are doing here, we are accessing objects with the class attribute. Like E1 is an object, with the help of that object, we are accessing the class attribute. Like class variables like E1.var, E1.var2, E1.var3. Then E2.var1, E2.var2, E2.var3. And the sum values, right? And then we are printing E2.var, E2.var1. And here we are calling E1.function. Basically, when we're declaring a function inside a class, we should keep this argument inside the function. This is the default structure you can see. Basically, when we are declaring a function, you should pass a parameter called self. And it is, you can say it is zero parameter. Like, jab aap isko call karte ho, you do not need to provide the value of it. Basically, it is a, you can say it is a default. It is necessary to write self. Kushbu is asking, ma'am, it is necessary to write self or we can write another argument. It is necessary to write argument. Sagar, there may be some error of indentation. You can correct that, right? Sometime we are writing the article, maybe there is some space issue can be created. So that you can correct by yourself, okay? So here not is also written, self is a kind of by default parameter. If we have a method which takes no argument, then we still have to have one argument called self. Got it? No ma'am, to argument name itself or we can put any other name of it. We should put the self. Okay, Kushbu? And this is the simple class we have created. Like I'll execute it, don't worry. There may be some errors. Var one. Where is var one? This one. No, it is not calling by itself. We are calling on with the help of even object here. You can say it is kind of syntax. Empty name and email y r of x y z. X is asking, I'm not getting empty name and email. Name and email are not empty, no? where one is xyz and then where two, it's small xyz, so it is calling this. This is very simple. Why you are getting confused? V2 में एबीसी का डेटा है, एक्स वाई जेड क्यों शो हो रहा है? V2 हैव एबीसीडी, बट व्हाट वी आर डूइंग हियर, E2 डॉट वेयर वन, दिस इज दिस सिंपली E2 डॉट वेयर वन, लाइक E2 इज कॉलिंग E2 डॉट वेयर वन, एबीसी इट इज प्रिंटिंग एबीसी, राइट? And then we are calling fun with the help of E1, right? Then you go to the fun and there are we are calling var1, var2 and var3. Axi, got it? Okay. It was difficult to me how to explain it because mujhe draw karna padta. Okay, you got it. Thank you. Okay, everyone. This is the aggregation I need to close. Reviews I need to close. Where is class? Okay, this one. Okay, guys. So simply, you can see the Python constructor. All these things you can read. I think it is self-understandable. Or I can explain you like how to create the constructor. Like in the Python, a constructor is a class function that begins with the double underscore. Basically, when you want to create a constructor in Python, then you need to write def a function and start with double underscore, then init an underscore, and then the parameters. This is the structure of the Python constructor. A constructor is a class function that begins with the double underscore. Constructor automatically called on the class object creation. Using underscore underscore init underscore underscore method, we can create constructor. Right? When we create a class without a constructor, Python automatically creates a default constructor that doesn't do anything. Like आप लोग जब भी कोई क्लास क्रिएट करते हो उसके साथ एक डिफॉल्ट कंस्ट्रक्टर क्रिएट हो जाते हैं, वो डिफॉल्ट कंस्ट्रक्टर आप नहीं क्रिएट कर रहे हैं तो कोई नीड नहीं है, वो सिंपली क्रिएट हो जाता है ऑब्जेक्ट इनिशियलाइज के लिए जब आप इनिशियलाइज करते हो ऑब्जेक्ट. और आपको कोई कंस्ट्रक्टर कॉल क्रिएट करना है और कुछ पैरामीटर के साथ क्रिएट करना है, लाइक डेफ अंडरस्कोर अंडरस्कोर इनिट अंडरस्कोर अंडरस्कोर सेल्फ एंड देन कॉमा, यू कैन गिव द अदर पैरामीटर्स, राइट? एंड यू कैन क्रिएट द फंक्शंस, यू नो ऑलरेडी. आई गॉट अ क्वेश्चन. Danielle is written, ma'am, now it's 7 o'clock, we are feeling tired. Just wait, I'm closing it, don't worry. Little bit I'm explaining कि आपको constructor लिखना है तो आप कैसे लिखेंगे, underscore 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 init underscore underscore, then constructor can be two type, parameterized and non-parameterized. ये constructor आप देख रहे हैं यहाँ पे, ये parameterized है जिसमें आप self comma एक parameter pass कर रहे हैं, okay? And non-parameterized, ये आपका non-parameterized constructor है जिसमें आप कुछ भी pass नहीं कर रहे. And deleting a class, then and then the class name. Okay, so we can conclude today's chapter. Like we have learned about the machine learning and we have learned about the some Python part of class and objects. And please go through these articles. You will get the more things in the detail. Safa is written, I just wanted to let you know that my Wi-Fi had some problems some days ago, so I was not able to submit summary, but I have printed out to a reference material So I was able to study, and yesterday Wi-Fi got fixed, so I gave many summaries together. Okay, Safa. Okay guys, that's all. Now I'm closing for the today because it's already over time. Okay, please read all the things, you will get the things, all the articles that I have teach you today, you will get the things. Yes, class is user defined. Yes, we are creating class. Sagar, I am providing the questions day by day. You can practice those questions. Okay? I have given two more questions today. Guys, please practice them and write the answers. Okay? Thank you all. Okay, bye bye.